Full scale test, countdown is following.
You car.
This year, the Volvo Cars Safety Centre Crash Lab celebrates its 20th anniversary. At the time of its opening, it was the most advanced crash lab in the world, and in many ways it still is today.
When inaugurating this facility 20 years ago, it was unique in its appearance, enabling us to recreate any type of crashes that our team find in the real world, with real people in real traffic.
Before a physical crash test, the car model has already gone through thousands of computer-simulated scenarios.
At Volvo, we set our own standards. We develop beyond what is rating and what is a legal requirement. We do that based on what we see in the field.
The crash lab contains two test tracks of 108 and 154 meters long, respectively. The shorter track is adjustable between 0 and 90 degrees, allowing for different crash angles. Cars can be crashed at speeds up to 120 kilometers per hour.
At Volvo Cars, we have a vision that no one should be seriously injured or killed in a new Volvo. Having that mindset in combination with very dedicated people, a dedicated organization, and facilities like this is really what makes the difference.
The outside area is used for performing tests like rollover crashes and runoff road scenarios, whereby cars are launched into a ditch at high speeds. Both the car and the barriers are fitted with sensors that register the entire chain of events in detail. Dozens of ultra-high definition cameras also film the impact from multiple angles. Since its opening in 2000, the lab has crashed on average one car every day.
Safety has been at the core of everything we do since 1927. For us, it has always been about protecting people.
I'm really excited with all the possibilities with electrification, connectivity, and autonomous drive. And I know this lab will continue to help us save lives also in the future.
Thank you.
ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Today we have dropped 10 cars from 30 meters from a crane. We do that because the rescue team or emergency service need to develop new methods to release people inside a car with a severe crash.
We are several different rescue services that cooperate to find the best practice in tools and methods and tactics regarding extrication in car accidents. Today we are testing our methods and really going about it in such a scientific way as we can. We try to measure everything, what pressure we use, how much force we have to use, how much time different methods take, all of those things. The goal is for us to be better at our job and to get access to people in crashed cars in less time.
Normally we crash cars in the laboratory, and this was the first time we dropped them from a crane. We see extreme deformation after the test. And we do this to give the rescue team a real challenge to work with.
There are some different scenarios where we do extrications in modern cars. For instance, when a car hits a larger vehicle, or when we have accidents in very high speed, or when we have situations where a car is hit where there are no crumple zones, for instance like the T-bone accident. In these kind of situations, the people in the car are usually in a critical situation. We usually talk about the golden hour, and that means we have to have the patient in the hospital at the latest 1 hour after the accident has happened. A problem we have as a fire brigade is that when we do train normally, we usually get our cars from scrapyards, and these cars are most often 10, 15, maybe 20 years old, and they work very differently from the cars today regarding safety and hardness in the steel and how they work when we try to open them up. So therefore it's extremely important for us to work with new cars. Our work here will end up in a report, and that's not just for us who's working here today. It will hopefully be used all over Sweden and possibly internationally too.
The reason that we work close together is because we have the same goal, and that's to have safe roads.
Subscribe now to UCAR, a point of reference for car fans since 2010.